What planet in the solar system is the largest? You are correct if you mention Jupiter. However, the planet is not only giant. Several of its secrets have captivated scientists. Our understanding of the giant planet has substantially increased due to several missions visiting the planet. What has been discovered about Jupiter by scientists? How has it changed our understanding of the Sun and our planet? Jupiter, the biggest planet in the solar system, is named for the Roman mythological king of the gods. This gas giant is a mystery covered in vivid clouds and battered by powerful winds that rash under rings and moons. Jupiter is simply massive. The planet has a mass that is more than twice as great as all other planets in the solar system. The Great Red Spot, the planet's largest storm, spans a region twice the breadth of Earth. You will see other marvels of the Great Red Spot. Jupiter has a volume huge enough to hold more than 1,300 Earths. In comparison, if Jupiter were the size of a basketball, Earth would be the size of a grape. Did you know Jupiter was most likely the first planet to form in the solar system? According to scientists, it was created from the Sun's leftover gases. Interestingly, if Jupiter had been 80 times larger when it formed, it would have become a star, but not in the same league as the Sun. Although it's inaccurate, some scientists refer to Jupiter as a failed star. This is due to Jupiter's lack of sufficient mass to start a fusion reaction in its core. Hydrogen atoms are fused under intense heat and pressure to form helium, generating light and heat. This is how stars produce energy. Jupiter is typically 483,682,810 miles, or 778,412,020 kilometers, from the Sun in its orbit. At perihelion, when Jupiter is closest to the Sun, it is 5.203 times further from the Sun than the Earth is from the Sun on average. At aphelion, when Jupiter is furthest from the Sun, the distance increases to 507,089,500 miles, or 816,081,400 kilometers from its current length of 460,276,100 miles, or 740,742,600 kilometers. After Venus and the Moon, Jupiter is the third brightest object in the solar system, making it visible without a telescope. Though many have seen the planet, they might not be familiar with it. Jupiter is likely visible in the sky if you observe a brilliant star. Even inexpensive binoculars may let you see Jupiter more clearly. But a telescope will give you a clearer picture. Even some of Jupiter's many moons may be visible. How would Jupiter appear if you define yourself? Given that studies suggest Jupiter formed from solar remnants, the giant planet's atmosphere resembles that of the Sun, which means it is primarily composed of hydrogen and helium. However, if you explore the planet, you will find a partially dissolved core. East-west solid winds in Jupiter's upper atmosphere cause the bright and dark bands you can see covering the planet. More than 335 miles per hour or 539 kilometers per hour is the dizzying speed at which they travel. In addition, frozen ammonia crystals are found in the white clouds in the light zones, whereas the darker clouds, which are blue and contain chemicals at the lowest visible levels, found in the dark belts are darker. These bands are fascinating because they are dynamic. They are constantly changing, and when it rains, you get diamonds instead of water. Scientists have found that Jupiter has the strongest magnetic field of all the planets, with a strength astoundingly 20,000 times greater than the Earth. This magnetic field is so potent that it traps charged particles like electrons and produces radiation lethal to humans. The direct targets of this intense radiation are the moons, which will be discussed in more detail later. Other than the Sun, Jupiter is a solar system object that emits the most radio waves, but scientists have also found other peculiarities about this enormous planet. For instance, Jupiter rotates faster than any other planet, so a day lasts less than 10 hours. The planet appears to bulge at the equator and flatten at the poles due to the rapid spin. The interaction of Jupiter's gravitational field and the Sun's gravitational field influences a group of over 11,000 intriguing asteroids clustered into regions preceding and following Jupiter in its orbit around the Sun. Named after characters in Homer's epic poem, The Iliad, a well-known story about the Trojan War, these asteroids are referred to as Trojans. Remember the great red spot we discussed earlier? What is it exactly and what gives it its reddish color? A massive storm called the Great Red Spot has been continuously blowing like a hurricane for more than 350 years. Italian astronomer Giovanni Cassini first recognized the storm in 1665. Its edge rotates counterclockwise at a rate of 430 to 680 kilometers per hour, 270 to 425 miles per hour. The anticyclone storm's counterclockwise motion and color can range from brick red to slightly brown. These are most likely the result of minute amounts of phosphorus and sulfur in the ammonia crystals that make up Jupiter's clouds. Although the rate may have slowed recently, the spot has been getting smaller for a while. The Great Red Spot is just one of many storms that Jupiter has, though. This year's data from the Juno spacecraft showed that convection, or heat rising from lower altitudes to the higher atmosphere, drives Jupiter's enormous polar cyclones. Similar to how ocean vortexes function on Earth, speaking of Jupiter would only be complete by mentioning its moons. This planet has the most resources in the solar system, with 79 known moons. Galileo Galilei discovered Jupiter's four largest moons, Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto, which is why they are sometimes referred to as the Galilean moons. Ganymede is Jupiter's largest moon in the solar system. This massive moon is larger than Pluto and Mercury combined. Ganymede is unique because it is the only moon with its own magnetic field. Last year, the Juno mission captured the terrifying scent of Ganymede's magnetic field. But that's not all there is to Ganymede. This planet-sized moon contains at least one ocean hidden beneath layers of ice. However, studies indicate that the moon may have multiple layers of ice and water stacked on top of one another. An atmospheric water vapor was discovered last year. More information about this fascinating moon will be released as the European Jupiter Icy Moons Explorer, or JUICE, spacecraft launches in 2023 and arrives in Jupiter's system in 2030. Io is another Jupiter moon worth exploring. This moon is our solar system's most volcanically active body. As Io orbits, Jupiter, the planet's enormous gravity, causes tides on its solid surface that rise 300 feet or 100 meters and generate enough heat to keep the volcanism going. More than 1 ton of material is released into space by these volcanoes every second, which contributes to the unusual radio waves coming from Jupiter. Io is colored yellow-orange because of the sulfur it emits. You must also bring up Jupiter's rings. NASA's Voyager 1 probe has proven that it has three rings. Jupiter has its own set of rings made of dust from some of the moons, unlike Saturn and Neptune, which have more obvious rings. The primary ring is more than 4,000 miles, or 6,400 kilometers broad, and around 20 miles, or 30 kilometers thick. Now that scientists have learned how Jupiter affects the entire solar system, we can return to its enormous size. Planets Neptune and Uranus have been blamed for being pushed away from the Sun by Jupiter's powerful gravity. The NICE model, which contends that Jupiter and other gas giants were responsible for the phenomenon known as the late heavy bombardment, is to blame for this. There was a moment, though, when the Earth and other surrounding planets were blasted by debris. Jupiter primarily safeguards our planet. Jupiter serves as the solar system's vacuum cleaner, preventing asteroids and comets from bombarding Earth and protecting the inner planets. Smaller objects can be sucked in and absorbed by the powerful gravity it produces, as seen in the 1994 collision between Jupiter and comet Shoemaker-Levy 9. Jupiter can launch objects outside the solar system entirely, but its gravity can also cause some things to move more quickly toward the inner planets. You might also be wondering whether there is a chance of life being on Jupiter. A hide in the clouds where the temperature is roughly 70 degrees Fahrenheit or 21 degrees Celsius is where scientists believe life would have to exist if it were to exist on Jupiter. The studies indicate that Jupiter has enough water to support life, so perhaps one day we will discover proof of life there. However, life is more likely to exist on Europa, one of Jupiter's moons. Marine life might be floating around in a radiation-shielded ocean that is hidden on the moon. That is our video for today. What are your thoughts on outstanding discoveries that researchers found at Jupiter? Share all of your thoughts with us in the comments section below. Well, that's all for now. This is Big Tech Media. See you again tomorrow. Keep in mind to like, share, and subscribe.